Like many Hebrew and Yiddish words, the word teshuvah is hard to pin down with a single English translation. It's usually rendered as repentance, which is fair because it certainly does describe a major element of tshuva, but in some ways it misses the boat. The word repentance is derived from an Indo-European root that means to cause pain. And while teshuvah may involve a certain amount of pain, it's kind of like growing pain. It's kind of like healthy pain. It's kind of like the pain of the muscles and tissues knitting together to form a stronger and healthier you. So in other words, teshuvah is actually a very happy process. It's actually full of simcha, full of joy and development. So it's not at all, you know, like hair shirts and self-flagellations and things like that. What is teshuvah? How do we translate it? It comes from a Hebrew root, shuv, which means to go back, to return, to bring oneself back to center, to take stock of one's values and to bring them into harmony with the desires of oneself, one's family, one's community, and with God. Not necessarily in that order. Teshuvah is really a very different process than repentance as a whole. And in Maimonides' great work, he goes through the actual steps, the process of teshuvah. He was the first thinker to codify all of these laws into a single book. And I look forward to learning about the process of teshuvah with you over the course of the 40 days of teshuvah from Rosh Chodesh Elul, the beginning of the month of Elul, to Yom Kippur itself. Thank you very much.